I am here to talk today about co-infections with COVID. Hi, this is Jacqueline and I'm back with my next video. So this is something that I wanted to discuss because usually there are other underlying conditions going on besides just COVID. So I know for a long time I was just blaming everything on the fact that I had COVID. But in the fall, I started to experience fatigue, and that really wasn't a symptom that I had had up until that point. So this was like August, September. This was after my Delta infection, and I just was noticing that I was feeling considerably more tired, low energy. So when I was looking back over my health history, I remembered that I had had mono when I was 13. And then I also remembered that when I was in college, I got really, really sick. So if you haven't seen my last video, that video is on reflections, and that has to do with reflecting back on the loss of my mother and watching her suffer through her own illness. Well, at that time when my mother had passed away, I was in graduate school. I was trying to juggle being a graduate student, recently losing a parent, working, and also just living the college life. And it was extremely taxing on me and extremely taxing on my immune system. So at that time, I ended up suffering from chronic sore throats. I mean, just the worst sore throats. I was having the swollen glands, and I was also extremely tired. So at that time, I was diagnosed with Epstein Barr virus, and I was put on Valtrex. If I can recall correctly, I think I was on Valtrex for probably 6 months. After that period of being on Valtrex for 6 months, I generally don't really remember a time in my life where I felt that Epstein-Barr was necessarily a factor. But after getting my second COVID infection, I just started to feel that maybe that was at play again. And we have seen a lot of correlations between people having Epstein-Barr and people having long COVID. So I went to my doctor and I asked to be tested for it. And it's very important that you get the early antigen test. Sometimes they don't test you for all four tests, and the picture can come back not quite complete, and it doesn't actually show a reactivation. So I went and I got tested, and it did show that I had a reactivation of Epstein-Barr. So this was sort of shining that light on what was contributing to my fatigue. I also was able to get back on Valtrex. And there's also this other formula from Byron White Formulas, especially for EBV and mono support, that I started to take. So why I mention this is because there were other things at play here that I really just wasn't aware of. So it is important to get tested for co-infections because it's possible that you can help treat the other things that are going on. Now, of course, they say, you know, this isn't a cure for EBV, and I get that. But for me personally, being on Valtrex, I do notice an improvement in energy and just the overall feeling of fatigue when I am taking the medication. Some other things that you can be tested for besides EBV is Lyme, CMV, molds, toxins, heavy metals, and also any type of vitamin or mineral deficiency. I also was tested for all the different vitamins and minerals, and it came back that I had a severe iodine deficiency. I had like zero iodine levels. Like, they were unreadable. That's how much that my iodine levels were just completely tanked from COVID. So I was put on an iodine supplement. And then when I retested several months later, I mean, my iodine levels are still on the low end, but at least they're actually registering on the scale. Again, make sure that you're getting tested for all of this stuff, because if you have vitamin or mineral deficiencies or something's going on with your thyroid or one of these co-infections are coming back, it's possible that you can get additional support to help those areas, and it could overall help you to feel better. I really did not want to keep being tested for more and more stuff and figuring out like what else is wrong. And you know, it's a lot of energy to go and get tested and be in contact with your doctor. But overall, I'm glad that I went and I got tested, and I was able to see that unfortunately EBV was reactivated, but it did start to kind of put the puzzle pieces together of why all of a sudden I was experiencing so much fatigue. So again, talk to your provider, talk to your team, look at what's going on, and try to get tested for all the things that you can, so hopefully you can get more support and start to feel better soon. So as you guys know, I do have some treatments coming up. I will keep you posted on everything. Right now, I'm just kind of focusing on my path forward, my treatment plan path forward, and I will be back with all of that information here very, very soon. So until then, as always, be well, stay safe, and peace.